great-grandfather met great-grandmother when she was a shy young miss. And great-grandfather won great-grandmother with words more or less like this. Lavender blue, dilly-dilly, lavender green. If I were king, dilly-dilly, I'd need a queen. Who told you so, dilly-dilly? Who told you so? I told myself, dilly-dilly, I told me so. If your dilly-dilly heart feels a dilly-dilly way, and if you'll answer yes, in a pretty little church on a dilly-dilly day, you'll be wed in a dilly-dilly dress of lavender blue, dilly-dilly, lavender green. Then I'll be king, dilly-dilly, and you'll be my queen. Dilly-dilly heart feels a dilly-dilly way, and if you'll answer yes, in a pretty little church on a dilly-dilly day, you'll be wed in a dilly-dilly dress of lavender blue, dilly-dilly, lavender green. Then I'll be king, dilly-dilly, and you'll be my queen. Mares they dotes and does they dotes and little lambs they divey, a kittledy divey too, wouldn't you? Yes, mares they dotes and does they dotes and little lambs they divey, a kittledy divey too, wouldn't you? Now if these words sound queer and funny to your ear, a little bit jumbled and jivey, saying mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy.
Oh! Mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy, a kittledy divey too.
I know this ditty is nutty as a fruitcake, goofy as a goon, silly as a loon. But some call it pretty, others call it crazy, but they all like to sing this tune.
Mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy, a kittledy divey too, wouldn't you? Mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy, a kittledy divey too, wouldn't you?
If the words sound queer and funny to your ear, a little bit jumbled and jivey, saying mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy.
Oh, mares eat oats and does eat oats and little lambs eat ivy, a kittledy divey too, wouldn't you? Dozy
dozy,
little lambsy divey, a
kittledy divey
too, wouldn't you?
A kittledy divey too, wouldn't you?
A kittledy divey too, wouldn't you?
In San Francisco town there lived a whale. She ate pork chops by the pail, by the pillbox, by the suitcase, by the bathtub, by the schooner. Her name is Sarah and she's a peach, but you can't leave food within her reach, nor nursemaids, nor Airedales, nor chocolate ice cream sodas. She eats a lot, but when she smiles, you can see her teeth for miles and miles, and her adenoids, and her spare ribs, and things too fierce to mention. Oh, what can you do in a case like that? What can you do but sit on your hat, or your toothbrush, or your grandmother, or anything else that's helpless?
Would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are?
Or would you rather be a mule? A mule is an animal with long, funny ears. He kicks up at anything he hears.
His back is brawny and his brain is weak. He's just plain stupid and a stubborn streak. And by the way, if we hate to go to school,
you may grow up to be a mule.
Or would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are?
Or would you rather be a pig? A pig is an animal with dirt on his face. His shoes are a terrible disgrace.
He's got no manners when he eats his food. He's fat and lazy and extremely rude. But if we don't care a feather or a fig,
you may grow up to be a pig.
Or would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar
and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a fish? A fish won't do anything but swim in a brook. He can't write his name or read a book. But then if that sort of life is what you want, you may grow up to be a fish, and all the monkeys aren't in the zoo.
Every day we meet quite a few.
So you see, it's all up to you. You can be better than you are.
We can be better than we are. Would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are?
Or would you rather be a mule? Or would you rather be a mule? Or would you rather be a mule?